As it stands now, about 50% of our babies that have the near total pancreatectomy for diffuse disease still have hypoglycemia after the surgery. They still need some form of medical management to keep their blood sugars from being too low. The other outcomes would be, instead of needing sugar, they'd have too high of a sugar and they'd have more like diabetes and need insulin. And then there's a small percentage that kind of find a balance and they don't need anything.
We have this multidisciplinary team that can provide ongoing care for their children even if their hyperinsulinism is not cured after surgery.
They've been doing mostly her toe?
Yeah.
Follow-up is really going to be determined by what their continuing needs are. As these babies gain weight, their support needs to increase with that weight gain. So it's not like we put them on a regimen and send them home and then it's never gonna have to change. HI is a dynamic disease, and so you need to adjust with the child's growth.
It's 151.
Okay.
People around the world know our center and they want to refer to us, and oftentimes they'll go through our international medicine program.
Because our patients come from overseas and from all over the United States, we work very hard at establishing collaboration with the local physicians that are going to be following these families long term.
It's really important for families to feel that they have a team that they know, a team that they've been able to build rapport with, a team that will listen to them. It really is a collaboration between the referring hospital, the family once they get to us, and then our team as a whole.